Yo. You two trolls catch my scimitar blade and turn snitch. Your man is your dog and your homegirl a bitch. Inquisition lies turn high priestess to witch. Burned at the stake, cooked like fish Escovitch. Cointel pro are not pros but rookies. TikTok program makes young girls shake their cookies. Transgenders wanna be called proper pronouns. D-Wade son turned daughter, pawn of the order. Used for the rituals, niggas wearing capris. Slam dunk champ shorts are way above his knees. By yourself with three masks on, that's a disease. Most of y'all are crack fiends for vaccines. Giving passes to perv clones like Weinstein. While in your favorite actor had property on Epstein Island. Hollywood Kazaj, tribe of 13 wizards. Blowing lies make visibility pour like blizzards. With sins greater than 55 miles per hour, stupidity will surely get your minds devoured. Using your soul to quench the thirst of diabolic devils. Then ignorance would rise past hyperbolic levels. Are you thinking or is your mind controlled? Are you blinking or is your first eye closed? Will you think and save yourself or fall victim? Will you fight back or keep getting your face kicked in? Are you thinking or is your mind controlled? Are you blinking or is your first eye closed? Will you think and save yourself or fall victim? Will you fight back or keep getting your face kicked in?
I put your head on the water and show you what's important. You need ear, of course, and more will appear. Anywhere I stand, Morocco is there. So no matter where I stand, my rights will be clear. The law of the land, signed by the air. Ooh, the true heir. Ownership, caught up in color, you disowned the ship. A black star with black people in it. Ship got off your way before Drewally boarded it. That's a smart plan by some hybrids.
Yo, you two trolls catch my scimitar blade and turn snitch. Your man is your dog and your homegirl a bitch. Inquisition lies turn high priestess to witch. Burned at the stake, cooked like fish Escovitch. Cointel pro are not pros but rookies. TikTok program makes young girls shake their cookies. Transgenders wanna be called proper pronouns. D-Wade son turned daughter, pawn of the order. Used for the rituals, niggas wearing capris. Slam dunk champ shorts are way above his knees. By yourself with three masks on, that's a disease. Most of y'all are crack fiends for vaccines. Giving passes to perv clones like Weinstein. While in your favorite actor had property on Epstein Island. Hollywood Kazaj, tribe of 13 wizards. Blowing lies make visibility pour like blizzards. With sins greater than 55 miles per hour, stupidity will surely get your minds devoured. Using your soul to quench the thirst of diabolic devils. Then ignorance would rise past hyperbolic levels. Are you thinking or is your mind controlled? Are you blinking or is your first eye closed? Will you think and save yourself or fall victim? Will you fight back or keep getting your face kicked in? Are you thinking or is your mind controlled? Are you blinking or is your first eye closed? Will you think and save yourself or fall victim? Will you fight back or keep getting your face kicked in?
I put your head on the water and show you what's important. You need ear, of course, and more will appear. Anywhere I stand, Morocco is there. So no matter where I stand, my rights will be clear. The law of the land, signed by the air. Ooh, the true heir. Ownership, caught up in color, you disown the ship. A black star with black people in it. Ship got off your way before Drewally boarded it. That's a smart plan by some hybrids. But the birds still fly with a message. A flag of culture, heritage, American Republic. Feeling like Carthage, you're driving cars, I'm riding elephants. You're thinking nothing relevant, black before every statement, you're an agent. Need I say more, I'm in 7-Eleven, you're thinking corner stores. Human rights declared, but how they corner yours?
Are you thinking or is your mind controlled? Are you blinking or is your first eye closed? Will you think and save yourself or fall victim? Will you fight back or keep getting your face kicked in? Are you thinking or is your mind controlled? Are you blinking or is your first eye closed? Will you think and save yourself or fall victim? Will you fight back or keep getting your face kicked in?
Bye.
catch me slipping. Pull up in spots, we got the drop, they never paid attention. No pot to piss and dirty project calls, conscious missing. Got people jumping on my line like I was going fishing. Bow to my sires. Past life flash right by us. Spike your food so you can't digest. I can't digress. Shining on vampires who can't process the moon over campfires. We on the move, breaking rules. No, they can't tie us, can't buy us. Manila envelope deniers. Control times, haters still clocking. Got dirty moors trying to resurrect the show for the real profit. They trying to get the profit like a dollar sign in brackets. Game of tennis, nigga, I'm just here to make the racket. These crooked governments got royalties and cuffs, and all we got is nationality, like art inside a gallery. So pardon my mentality. Bloodline stretching like an empire. That's all the way from Barbary to Tartary. My mind's ecclesiastic. Prophets show me proofs inside the circle. Seven Asiatic. We not Negro, Black, or colored. Don't thug it out for nothing. Never catch me slipping. Pull up the spots, we got the drop. They never paid attention. No pot to piss and dirty project calls, conscious missing. Got people jumping on my line like I was going fishing. Back on my mission, packed up all my ammunition. Backed up all this competition. They don't got this kind of vision. No, no. These are the new days of our lives. All my time, he ticking. Copy by the minute. Got these chakras spinning.
Seven in the quadrants. G between the compass squares. Samson between Boaz and Yoakum. Never scared. Ships arrive in thousands. We are not alone. The way some think, I think they are not us, but clones. Looking up drones, staring back. Got track 5G phones, implants. Check their heads and their backs. Adam's apple big. What kind of female is that? Eyes color change like a chameleon. Plus under wave tracks. Wire sticking out. Cyborg holes. Miss Frankenstein. No protection needed. Self-lubricating vagina. So anthropomorphic. Can go for more dick than he can give it. An android goes livid. Skynet is NSA. Surveillance is global. Since refusal to be noble. Force creed is Constantinople. Force GMO. Nanotech air clouds. Sound weapons. Heart attack guns for non-social distance crowds.
Don't thug it out for nothing. Never catch me slipping. Pull up the spots. We got the drop. They never paid attention. No pot to piss and dirty project calls. Conscious missing. Got people jumping on my line like I was going fishing. Back on my mission. Packed up all my ammunition. Backed up all this competition. They don't got this kind of vision. No, no. These are the new days of our lives. All my time he ticking. Copy by the minute. Got these chakras spinning. Spinning.
This is what you need to know. Stuff you need to know, fellas. Ladies. Stuff you need to know.
Yeah. So we genetically bred for war. This Magister says genetically bred for war.
Hitchmanati.
I hold you, man, son. I'm genetically bred for war.
H-S-1-Patriot.
Genetically bred for war.
Lousy.
Sort of mouth, settle the score.
The camouflage, barrage of deception. Bent on destruction, alert enemy detection. Mobilized henchmen, spreading microphone terrorism. Electronic sound waves, we blessed it, I'm wetting them. Spreading efficiency like third world fishermen. On a mission to reinstate the legacy that was perverted and stolen. Sword exposing, muzzle full organ. All y'all sound boring. Trapped in the ecosystem of murder, fornication. Spit rays illuminate the mind, now mean sunlight. Vampires ignite, day or night. Streams burn to this, soldiers secure the throne to this. Raise fists, life paw, rise with the morning star, line raw. Kipura, Rastafari, Bonabati guy, all informer types. Selassie, I master my inner lights. Reaching higher heights, where devils get sliced and diced. Kinda like miss me, when the blade of our wars unsheathed. Population fall victim, my blade on slot. Global war campaigns, when I ink the page. Searing pain, I'm fools in the brain. Combatants left main, souls get claimed. Covered the throne like a king, bells ring. Dubs stick to win, formulate my curve with divine trick. Countermeasure, hate you so fast, you swear as a make. Pump round after round you like a sick. Cock your wig, use it as a headdress and place it on my flip wig. Walk down your block just to prove my point. I'm supreme white, switching into skin buds. You fairy bone, you debone, you got no bone, you just bristle. Death on one, launch the missile.
War, war, war. Yeah. Genetically bred for war, I'll be genetics So don't forget, cause we genetically bred for war. So we genetically bred for war. And we genetically bred for war. Genetically bred for war. So I'm genetically bred for war. Genetically bred for war. He's genetically bred for war. I leave the crime scene with my war face painted in green. Cops got no time to stop me or intervene. That's why I'm the devil killing machine. Sometimes a fiend to dismember the head of the enemy that lurks in the sitting man. Head at the dragon and the eagle working as a vet. Men instead of wanting me alive, they just want me dead. Or that's what I read. They chase me, I chase them. Like a never ending war, there's more to replace them. The only way to win is by destroying the main station. Manufacture rips out walls waiting for placement. Fire up on your agents, this world's ran by nations. Live in subterranean lives cause they facing. Prophesied rebel warmonger action taken. Watch that movie soldiers, cause that's just what they making. It's all about pride, but you can't run a hide unless you choose suicide. Try to tap into my mind, access denied, leave your brains fried. Like 6,000 watts, pump to my fortune to keep you out, but at least you tried. If you want to collide, with Charlie whispered them, warning you're in for a ride. That's like a doomsday asteroid, touching down on the planet Earth, watch with killjoy. Riding off the crash course, now it's time to destroy. Babylon toppling the empires to make way. What a nice to break day. I'm a Night Stalking IHF member, believe that. Mossad agents ease back. No remorse can stop me. Shot on sight, don't give me feedback. Yeah. Genetically bred for war. So we genetically bred for war. Cause we genetically bred for war. So we genetically bred for war. So we genetically bred for war. Genetically bred for war. So I'm genetically bred for war. Genetically bred for war.
Genetically bred for war. Hearts at your door. Blood impaling seeds of rotten evil weeds. And run the massacring MCs. Rivers overflow with bodies. Fierce war gas compositions. Robotic lava leaving third degree burns and blisters. Microphone condensing vapor. Nuclear rolling thunder. ICBMs erase ya. Ghost dance. Can't catch your moves like a zombie. The trans hands, Zulu art of war, fuck dudes, anarchy becomes Ron rule, hell's breaking loose, commandos start the coup, initiate operation overthrow, RLA in camp on your banks, Twilight can we attack your flank, leaving my mortar around CCP, JP, kiss off the shelves, decimate compounds, 4540 cars, renegade A1 mercenary cowboys, joint chiefs and staff generals, running up stranglers on search and destroy missions, daytime, wartime, executioners, peacemakers, hip-hop dictators, judgment of forces, face disfigurers, pain distributors, broken butcherers, knowledge is a weapon, so henchmen, let's cripple their minds. Third of war now playing, and we ain't playing. Nor do we the slave, or cold and frigid. Behold black and white magic on turf. Lure seasons, centuries into the ambush. Rotate on burst while we spit foul words. Enacting our generational curse. Set up, net up words, like God sending lightning bolts. Like an uprise revolt. Like a Hollywood thug making streets light up with fireworks. Come out unscathed, unhurt. Come out of hell, undefiled and uncooked. I'm in the form of double-edged swords, arrows. High-powered gas. Spears, no life is spared.
War, war,
no life is spared. Commercial rappers, no life, no life. Commercial rappers,
whirlwind, judgment.
No radio ever.
Headrush
charges, genetic bred for war. Fuck it up.
Hey, we're not
genetic bred for war. No mistakes.
Yeah, yeah, war, war.
We all like that.
Kundalini through their mind, that's a closet with the prime. Illusionary time was not, time was not. We've been here, brain full of thoughts, electrical. While ears calling death from you, words big power, make you move. Like quasi-citizen, I'm more national. Sellouts only know, they're the ones that had the flow. They're the ones with all the dough. Always placing the stone on the hole. A story never told, just rewritten. This one's that they're a strike. Don't plan to get you. The demon's gonna get you. The demon's coming to get you. The demon's gonna get you. The demon's gonna get you. If you're not in persona, if you're not in persona.
Read about the books in your face now. These thoughts I pull up like the way pal. And that ain't loving folk, y'all talk. Stay diligent and pave the way like the boardwalk. Fresh as a horse, threads the attire. I might be spoiled, but my ID don't expire. Might be not self-identifying, they a liar. Took a fall, then bounced back, even higher. Ascending off, if I ain't dead, then it's dark. What I'm saying is, I'm the light, started from a spark. Big bang, more than look. Rain. This is state body, this is not a game. But it's red flags waving. We woke now, the whole world been waiting. No debates, just receipts, still elated. Drew Ali brought you everything.
New York Rangers, Dark Horse, Demons Bash, Demons gonna get you. 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 It's not the persona, it's not the persona. Demons gonna get you. Demons back to get you. Demons gonna get you. Demons gonna get you. Demons gonna get you. Demons gonna get you.
Freddy Demons, Google God, I'm sleepy-headed as expected. Sell your children to dirty rabbis and creepy reverends. Abandon the Republican form, like it's the norm to be stateless. Those brainless have minds very spacious. This is Drew Ali online, I see you stay faceless. Tie dirty to the grill and leave heaven gateless. In the constitutional fold, psychopathic inferiors running to the facto governor generals. Lake is more superior than these so-called officials with their quote-unquotes. Selling out for banknotes, strong votes and scapegoats. Cut or sore throat for turncoats, burn bridges and burn boats and cannons. Baphomet, headshot, Shannon ritual. Conscious on metaphysical. Mars on meta-spiritual, meta-lyrical and visual. Upside down the 5-point star and go mystical.
New York players, dying girls, dying girls, dying girls.
Hmm. 2014, 9 years ago, 2014, why, how come, okay, look at it like this, I'm Cherokee and Blackfoot, but that's only the tribal name. That's not really who we are. The nation is Moabite Moor. Our biggest mistake is identifying ourselves by the tribes. Moorish Master Teacher Taj Tariq Bey. He's Cherokee and Blackfoot, and he knows that he's Moor. And then you're going to have, you know, certain jackasses out here that are going to be saying they're whatever. They'll say they're Hebrew American Indian. And they're indigenous and aboriginal. But they got L. Now when L is Canaanite, L is Moorish. L is Moorish. You never hear none of these whoever's saying that they're L's and all that. They ain't saying that. They have to be studying Moors to do that. Noble Drew Ali said he's a Moor. Noble Drew Ali said he's a Moor. Everybody knows Noble Drew Ali's Cherokee. Everybody knows Noble Drew Ali was born North Carolina. That's over here. That's not Africa. When you trace him back, his lineage been over here. He didn't come here on ships from anywhere. Been here. it's hard for people to get because majority of people have been conditioned. They haven't learned anything. They've been conditioned. They've been conditioned. Keep in mind, this is world language. This isn't limited to some North America only. That these people are the indigenous people. They're the first people on the planet, and they never left the continent of North America. They just stayed. They just were over there. They were just in North America, and that's it. They never took a boat, went on the ocean to see what's on the other side or anything like that. The cowards. These cowards didn't navigate, circumnavigate the globe. These navigators that went back and forth on flat earth or whatever it is, everybody knows those were the Moors. Everybody knows the navigators, the ones who traveled everywhere, took everything everywhere. There wasn't some indigenous people from Australia that did that. It wasn't some indigenous people from America that did that. It wasn't them that did that. They claim they're the first people. They claim they're the first people, but they're living off buffaloes. You living off buffaloes? That's what kind of savagery is that? What are you talking about? You living off buffaloes? What type of savage, backward people are you people? You're not even like, that's how you know that. The people who they're claiming are indigenous obviously are not indigenous. Because if a European could pay $5 to be one of them, obviously they're not indigenous. To the point where right now, 2023, right now, you go look up every Indian tribe, and I bet you the chief is a European. Pale face. Bet you. And then if you talk to some Negro, black or colored Indian, if you talk to them, they're going to show you their black chief or whatever, Chief Strong Eagle and all this BS. They're gonna bring their chief. Say, but we have a black chief. Those aren't the real. So if those aren't the real, whatever, then why aren't you fighting them? Why are you debating Mars? If the people who are Europeans right now, that are saying that they're the Indians, right? How come these black Indian whoevers aren't going at the pale Indians more than Moors? Because it seems like their problem is really the pale Indian people who are stealing their birthright. They're worrying about what Moors are doing. You people never worry about what Moors are doing. You were in the bushes or whatever with your little hut and all that stuff, and you were living your little berry picking life. Your little baskets, and you go pick your little flowers and all that stuff, and you be indigenous people. There you go. Founders of civilization, they're not hunter-gatherer niggers. They're not them. They're not them. They're civilized human beings. The hell do you think there's things over here because of some kill a bear to make a jacket, Indians? The hell out of here. This is curry mallet. Curry mallet. Teaching Native American across the curriculum. The evidence that suggests that there was a significant diffusionary African presence in the Americas like the evidence that suggests that ancient Egyptians and later the Moors who invaded Spain in 711 AD, occupying it until 1492, and in the process lifting Europe out of their dark ages, were black and not white, is so overwhelmingly conclusive that Eurocentric archaeologists and historians has gone to great lengths to prove otherwise. Chandler summarizes this same point, notes that the black Moors have been subject to the same mistreatment as have other African or African-influenced cultures, the Olmec, the Egyptian, the Harappan of the Indus Valley, for same reasons. For example, the conclusion that the ancient stone and clay portraits mentioned above found in Central America, identifying as indisputably African and Negroid in characteristics, and therefore presented as evidence for the ancient African presence in America, has been dismissed by Eurocentric historians and is thus explained as the result not of a long period of African and South American contact, but the result of the random creativity of pre-Columbian artists. Now let's look at this. From the conclusion, the people of Central America are indisputably African and Negro in characteristics. The dismissing of Moors being in America is Eurocentric. It's Eurocentric thinking to dispute, to have a critique, to have an opinion in the negative towards Moors being in America. Because like they told you, the evidence suggests that the ancient Egyptians and later the Moors. So if Tahuti was in America, if Tahuti was in America, then the scope that people have of Egypt has been off. Why? Because they've been thinking like Europeans. They haven't been thinking like their foremothers and forefathers, like Noble Drew Ali told them to do. They're thinking like the modern European. And when you think like the modern European, Egypt to you is only over there. Moors are only over there. And then over here, there were these grass skirt people running around with bow and arrows and all that stuff in little tribes all over. That's European thinking. Because there's pyramids over here. There's so much ancient Egyptian things in America that there's a cover-up. You could go research it yourself and see that there's an actual cover-up. Why is ancient Egypt over here? And they're trying to cover it up. Still, 2023, they're still trying to cover it up. Pope even came out and dismissed the doctrine of discovery. And these people are still not going to give up the goods about what's really up with over here and where over here really is. Because I guarantee you, If you ask any other national, not dumb nigger, we're talking about if you ask another national. I was doing some research and I found out that at one time, Africa was connected to America. To the point that they found parts of Africa under America right now, 2023. So wouldn't that mean that America and Africa are the same place? And all those other nationals are gonna look at you funny. Because they're gonna wanna know how you know. Who are you that you know that? Because niggers don't know stuff. Niggers don't know who they are. That's why they always get taken advantage of. And everybody knows. They keep getting taken advantage of. By others when they're in their own land. And the evidence is there. That is one landmass, people going back and forth on the one landmass. It's a great earthquake. And the land got separated. And then whoever's where they're at, that's where you're at. Unless you're going to get in a boat and go try to find the other, which didn't happen until the ancient Phoenicians and all the crew who had fleets of boats and all that going across the Atlantic Ocean. Fleets. 100 ships. Obviously, you know where you're going if you're taking 100 ships. And when we got over here, we saw the same people. We saw the same people. I know it's a lot, but you have to face reality that you've been played. You've been played. Don't get mad. Get wise. Afro and Indigenous Intersectionality by Larry W. Miles. Jackson explains that the 19th century Oxford Dictionary suggested that during the Middle Ages and as late as the 17th century, anyone considered to be of very dark complexion or very swarthy were called Moors. During the Middle Ages and as late as the 17th century, anyone considered to be of very dark complexion or very swarthy were called Moors. Anyone. Anyone. So are they lying and telling people black Indians, just call them Moors? Because they're dark skin, aren't they? Are they dark skin? Yes, okay, fine. So they're Moors. Because anyone to be of very dark complexion or very swarthy were called Moors. And according to Dr. Ben, the Moors called what people say Africa, Al-Kabilan. The Moors named it Al-Kabilan. Then some Europeans came, and then now it's Africa, and then everybody's calling it that. Why? European thinking. Eurocentric mindset. Eurocentric mindset. The word Moor would be supplanted by the word Negro. And eventually, all the monikers that would shape the identities of Negro, Black, colored, African American people would be also. But before we move on, we should address some of the controversies regarding the ethnic, racial, and cultural origins of Moors. Texts written in Arabic language very rarely use the word Moor to identify particular ethnic groups. For some Arabic chroniclers, distinctions would be made between the non-Arabic speaking people of North Africa. It was at one point believed that the term Berber was a pejorative used for many groups of Northwestern Africans. However, Berber could also be referred to as Moors. Along with Berbers being grouped in as Moors, there would also be cultural distinctions like clan names used to identify the people. In addition, early Christian sources often applied the term Saracen indiscriminately to Muslim populations in general, including the Moors. So you're realizing that every brand name is created so you're not called Moor? Because no matter what they do, you can't get around the fact that anybody who's dark-skinned is a Moor. You can't go anywhere without that. You can't go anywhere without that. When they refer to the Moors in antiquity, what do you think they what are you missing? What has the people so brain froze that it's almost like they can't think or something? That their ability to think has been cut off or disconnected. Because it's impossible for us to be keep playing these fiction, we don't know who we are, call ourselves all types of BS, when we could just call ourselves Moors and everybody knows that that's who we are. Look again. This is American Monthly Review, 1894, Volume 9. The origin of the name America. The much debated question of the origin of the name America is considered by Dr. John Murray of the Challenger Expedition in a most interesting article in the Scottish Geographical Magazine for November. He points out that in the Cantino map, the oldest but one of the New World, prepared in part, it is believed, by Vespucci, the name Tamarique occurs. T-A-M, let me give you the Zumas. The name Tamarique, T-A-M-A-R-I-Q-U-E, Tamarique, occurs towards Darien and in the direction of Nicaragua. To this day, a little to the westward of Nicaragua is a range of mountains called Sierra Amerique, Amerrique, inhabited by a tribe once widely extended called Amerriques or Americas. Amerriques. Again, Amarca, Amarca, or America, is shown by their sacred book to have been the national name of the Peruvians. Peruvians are before Europeans came over here, aren't they? They've been here, right? Isn't it interesting that the word America was used by the Peruvians as their national name? National name? Remember this 1800s? The national name? The Peruvians was national name in 1800s? So Juali obviously had a pretty legit template that he could do to set up for the Moors in America, who are descendants of Moroccans. And woke up out the spell because he realized that you're not Negro black colored. You're not Indian. Nobody's playing games with you. You're Moors. You dark skin? You're kind of brown. You're Moor. Stop the BS. Now you're making this stuff advanced. This is not some secret stuff in some vault. This is just Google. Google and then push all. And stuff is coming up. There's not some stuff that I pulled out of some whatever. Just some stuff right before this. I just looked this up. Ancient America names. What's the ancient America names? And something's coming up. 1894. What more you want? If it's that simple. Because remember, this is the article. So this can't be refuted. This article. This was fact-checked before it was put out. So this is not some fiction. Tamarique is therefore supposed to stand for Terra Amerique. Terra Amerique. It was an age of nicknames. What more natural than that Vespucci should be called America Vespucci? His Christian name of Amerigo would lend itself, his Christian name of Amerigo will lend himself even suggests the nickname. It is possible that the New World may have given Vespucci his celebrated name of Americus, and not Vespucci his Christian name to the New World. How much has to be told to these downtrodden, non-thinking Negroes to take their head out the sand and recognize that you don't have any options. Everything that you've tried failed miserably. And all there is the Moorish paradigm that you never tried. Because you tried all the other BS. Look where we are as a people. The last time we were prominent and prosperous as a people is when we were Moors. After we stopped being Moors, then everything fell to shit. So what's that tell you? It'd be wise to probably get back on what the Moors were on. Since when the Moors were ruling, everything was good. Everybody was good. There was no issues. in the world? No issues? All you gotta do is just say you're gonna be under the Moors. What's the problem? You got castles and running water and all this. Like, what's the problem? We give honors for Noble Drew Ali, the Cherokee, the sachem that all the Indian whoever is supposed to be recognizing him as the prophet too, if they're Indian. If they're Indian and they're from the tribe and all that stuff, then they should be given honors to Noble Drew Ali because he's their head too. He's their head too. If he's the Washita prince, then why wouldn't the indigenous people be following him as their prophet as well? Just like the Moors when we went to New Brunswick, and the Moors who were there, they got the portrait of Noble Drew Ali on their front door. They're on the reserve, but reserve whoever's do have jurisdiction over them. Because that whole community knew them since they were small, and they already know that they're part of the tribe. But now they know more science. Now they're understanding FOH with all that Indian cards and all that. And the Indian whoever's are going with them. Like, okay, yeah, fine. Well, all right, fine. Do whatever you want to do then. Crack the code. Just saying that they're Moors on a reserve. So you think that is not going to be the same for the Negro, Black, Colored? We know Hebrew Israelites who are Moors. You know Hebrew Israelites who are Moors? We know occultists, metaphysicians who are Moors? Like, we know Native Americans who are Moors. And they got their L and all that stuff, and they're not playing any Hebrew games. You know, people who come from the so-called tribes, that they know that they're not a tribe. They're a national. So they have a nationality, just like every other civilized being. They're not a ward. Not calling yourselves a fiction. This is not India, but you're calling yourself Indian. Not making sense. This is not India, so you can't be Indian. And then on top of that fraud, then you're going to come attach some tribes onto that fraud. This is Noble Drew Ali. Keep in mind, right? Keep in mind, Noble Drew Ali is 1920s, and this is before all these people. You find me some whoever that was a black Indian that was going around telling people about that they're Indians in the 1920s. You know there are people going around promoting the colored stuff. We know there are people going around promoting the Back to Africa stuff. We know there are people going around saying that they're Moors. You know, people are going around saying that they're Moorish Jews. Well, I don't know anybody who was Indian going around telling people about They're not Negro, black, colored, they're Indian. This Indian stuff just came up, it just came yesterday. People are late. The Moabites from the land of Moab, who received permission from the pharaohs of Egypt to settle and inhabit northwest Africa, they were the founders and are the true possessors of the present Moroccan Empire, with their Canaanite, Hittite, and Amorite brethren who sojourned from the land of Canaan seeking new homes. Their dominion and inhabitation extended from northeast and southwest Africa, across the great Atlantis, even onto the present North, South, and Central America, and also Mexico and the Atlantis Islands, before the great earthquake which caused the great Atlantic Ocean. Does that sound like religion to you, or does that sound like history? Does that sound like reference points? Does that sound like he's saying you're Aboriginal and Indigenous to the Americas? Because if you're talking about Moabites and Canaanites and all that stuff, he's talking about before some European came over here. Right? He's definitely talking about before some European came over here. If he's talking about Moabites. And the Moabites got permission from the pharaohs of Egypt to settle and inhabit north, west. And remember, where did they say that they found chunks of Africa under America? So no matter how many earthquakes they have and how much land splits or whatever like that, it was all one landmass. Stuff is really easy to figure out. It's not advanced at all. But because our people are brainwashed and under mental slavery and they got PTHD and PQRST and whatever other stuff, ADHD and whatever else they got. They got everything else. Right? Their dominion and inhabitation extended from northeast and southwest Africa across the great Atlantis. 1920s, he's telling people about Atlantis. 1920s? Even unto the present North, South, and Central America, and also Mexico and Atlantis Islands. Before the great earthquake which caused the great Atlantic Ocean. Before the great earthquake. Before? So before the great earthquake, everything was connected? The only way he's going to pass over Atlantis is if there's land there. Across the great Atlantis. Across the great Atlantis. Not across the great Atlantic Ocean like our European-minded scholars have been training you to think. That's not what we're talking about. Now, what they call Caribbean is Atlantis Islands. Those are Atlantis Islands. If their dominion and inhabitation extended from over there to over here than they're aboriginal to the land, because it's one landmass. And know that it's a lot. It's a lot for our people to digest, because they've been so conditioned that, you know, you give them too much, they go back to sleep, or their brain turn to water, or they start, you know, they glitching. They start short circuiting, the little sparks coming out the ears and all that. Right? This is the importance of what it is that Moors are doing. Because what Moors are doing is doing their best to wake our people up, because you can't do anything else until you're out of this dead status. Nothing is going to work. And if you think it worked, don't worry. You're going to leave this physical plane and going to have to go to the next spot, wherever that is that you're going to go. And you'll see if the stuff you did here is going to pay off when you go over there. You'll see. If you think, you know, you got away with something over here. Right? So as soon as they start talking about, you know, Moroccan Empire, and then you have these other people talking about Island of Turtles and all that. And then you're not even comprehending that these people are a dumbass because they're calling a continent an island. Obviously, they're a dumbass. Because why would you not say a turtle continent? Why would you call a continent an island? A continent's not an island. Those things aren't the same. A continent's an island? Since when? Since when is a continent an island? Man, they're gonna show you drawings and all that stuff. Say, see, it looks like a turtle. No, it doesn't. It looks like a turtle. How does North America look like a turtle? The hell are you talking about? And then why are you calling a continent an island? Are you dumb? Right? Of course, if the colonist is ruling, yes, you're on Indian land. If the colonist is ruling, yeah, this is Indian land. Indians in the Constitution and all that stuff, yeah. Yeah, because that's worship. We're not denying that there's Indian land. We know that there's Indian land, but that's a fiction. Just like we know that there's black people, and that's a fiction. And again, all these fiction people are the same ones that's bringing in the trans agenda that you're dealing with right now, being something that they're not. That's who opened the door for them, the Negro, black, colored whoevers, black Indian tribe whoevers. Being something other than Moors opened the door for all this stuff your children got to do with these trannies and stuff now. Playing fictions. Right? Don't get caught being a fiction. Drew Ali told you. Remember, Drew Ali told you. Remember that Drew Ali told you the truth about your nationality and your birthrights. What you do with it after that is up to you. But just know that after you leave this plane, you're going to have to deal with the BS that you left here. So you better do opposite of the Moors during Drew Ali's time and do right by him. Do right by him. Just do your best to do right. You gotta do nothing extravagant and all that stuff. Just be right. That's all. He's not even asking for much. Just be right. And everything will be straight. Because, you know, you already know everything's good with Moors. You know what I mean? Like, it is what it is. But I know Moors stuff's good. Moors complaining about too much stuff. Everything's all right for Moors. Yeah. Honors to all the Moors worldwide. Honors to all the mothers. Honors to all the Moors in the chat. Honors to all the Moors in the chat. Peace and love to all the faithful. All the faithful Moors. Peace and love to all the faithful Moors. And supreme honors to the Prophet, Noble Drew Ali. Islam to all the Moors.
Come closer, let me tell you a little something. Come closer, let me tell you a little something. Come closer, let me tell you something. Come closer, let me tell you a little something. Come closer, let me tell you something.
They thought we were N-I-G-G-E-R. Until we showed them that we G-O-D, we God. Walking around the earth in the flesh. You gotta be your best at your best. Whether right or wrong, up or down, left or right, side to side. No tattoos, man. No Tai Chi's, man. I never went to jail and don't wanna go there, man. I took a look at you and be like, yo, like, hot damn. What's up with the purse? I'm what's up with the skirt? I'm what's up with the makeup? I'm what's up with the lipstick? You wearing high heels? You not a man, man. You are a man's man. You from the Stone Age land. You like, bam, 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 bam.
Come closer, let me tell you a little something. Come closer, let me tell you something. Come closer, let me tell you a little something. Come closer, let me tell you something. Come closer, let me tell you a little something. Come closer, let me tell you something. Come closer, let me tell you a little something. Come closer, let me tell you something.
Secrets of the afterlife manifest the present day. Dirty moths and scoundrels lose their heads in a pleasant way. Deceit and deception, negative past thoughts keeps awareness on point. Spirit messages never off. Inner realizations encounter the higher selves. Next plane existence explains my consistence. Without a foe, you never know. So path most resistant. Divinity, my twin flame, side chick and mistress. metaphysic, Kabbalistic, Almarok mystic, patriarch papistics, make my thoughts sadistic, so indigenous, call me Americanistic, invoking the ancestors, Saracen cryptic, suns on rotation, flows ecliptic, shatter all illusions, reveal the realistic, sitting in the dark, holding the light marvelous, recognize the artifice, skin so carbonous, hair so antenna, I feel them from Vienna, myriad of virtues, lessons in reptilian henna, enlightenment seekers won't find it in mainstream, focus as a laser, stay balanced like a beam, not even a gymnast, whenever I flip this, as above so below, get out when within this, don't think I'm a slave cause I speak in English, Drew Ali the water, watch your flames get extinguished, living in your higher lower self is relinquished, reputation of master teachers, call it distinguished. Self-drawn, wanna touch my antennas and steal my energy, eyes bulge, telling them my boy was King Edward V. When it comes to facts, with laws they get beggarly, they ask Morocco where, the farthest northwesterly, with every question asked I respond cleverly, all dependents won't explain expertly, going in their wallets, pull out pictures with fezzes, breaking down the ring, then the mason confesses, he's at 33 degrees, now the convo stretches like yoga, into esoteric metaphysic lessons, when my people aren't like me, he impresses, when we take more of science to the highways and hedges, this is what it feels like. This is what it feels like. This is what it feels like. This is what it feels like.
Try to get you to think again. That's the prophet. I'm upright, don't need a friend. And you can't stop this. I'ma write with my pen. Violate me and I'ma sin rinse again. Remain calm, shake us off, then they sin again. They send the police out just to silence men. When they bust through your door, you won't breathe again. Nationality will show you how to live again. It can change the predicament you're living in. You can heal the whole world without medicine. Only truth can make you a better man. Why lie? Cause you got paid to murder men. Then you try to lock them up when they riot in. That's okay, cause for freedom I'm diving in. With no knowledge, you come back to die again. Resurrect me not, cause I'd rather be one when I lie.
This is what it feels like. This is what it feels like. This is what it feels like. This is what it feels like.
Thank you. initiates of the sacred brotherhood of elite MCs. Rhyme mysterious initiates of the sacred brotherhood of elite MCs. Rhyme mysterious initiates of the sacred brotherhood of elite MCs. Rhyme mysterious initiates of the sacred brotherhood of elite MCs. Rhyme mysterious. Money is happy when wars are happy. Vixens wink fake lashes trying to trap me. 40 days and nights battling the lower demons. This is not the land, hybrids can't be freemen. If this is not the land, who's the immigrant thinking they're sovereign? Imagination figment, recessive is their status, lacking pigment. Game for the thanksgiving, but no commitment to indigenous moors they conquered with Bibles. Signs in the vitals and signs in the cycles, only to strangle, embracing my rivals. Free national standards, not playing with the tribals. Each moor is their own Christ, not disciples. Whether hands or thoughts, no worshiping idols. Always carry my Moorish Quran or recitals. Everyone will not process ancient's arrivals. Initiates of the sacred brotherhood of elite MCs. Rhyme mysterious initiates of the sacred brotherhood of elite MCs. Rhyme mysterious initiates of the sacred brotherhood of elite MCs. Rhyme mysterious initiates of the sacred brotherhood of elite MCs. Rhyme mysterious.
Mystic ability to show and prove a lesson, coupled with the agility to move you with the message. Presence of divine mind to navigate you with a reference. Urgent with a purpose, perfect. Emerging urban legends. Real morals, not a question or a choice or a preference. You are who you are, you should have the same obsession. Broke the same jewels to a dude, the corner Jane and Western. What you repping, all that effort, that direction. Keep you separate in a world of blind sheep. I was born to be a shepherd, mind like an elephant. Got the powers of a leopard, means I'm wise and I'm strong. Crank you up like I'm a record, take you to the body shop. Correctulize the truth, vector manifestations. Matter, energy, and mind, spirit, man, unsung. Trey Young dropping dimes. Until you tighten up, you catch the splinters from the pine. Clean the clouds out your thoughts, that's what keep you in the bind.
Initiates of the sacred brotherhood of elite MCs. Rhyme mysterious initiates of the sacred brotherhood of elite MCs. Rhyme mysterious initiates of the sacred brotherhood of elite MCs. Rhyme mysterious initiates of the sacred brotherhood of elite MCs. Rhyme mysterious.
Peace, Moors, Islam. Just a quick one. Just a quick one. Just that Dru Ali's the man, we already know. But you know, we might as well.
Common sense was made before book sense. Canaan Land Moors presents Common Sense.
Legendary, bury me in the north gates. Cemetery, February the 4th day. Son of Mary, day ahead of my born day. Independence and law makes it a little of a lost case. With case laws, we break them down like Jericho. Keeping all my lions tamed, I'm Chris Jericho. I'll keep a mask on deck, I'm Rey Mysterio. Fake pandemics announced over the radio. Annoyed with the game, the joys and the pains. I'm rock bass, mix it with rock the hard way. I was in a lost state. Prophets stood me upright, brought me to a lost gate. Cooking like I'm Salt Bae, rapping like I'm Denzel. Malcolm X, Deja Vu, Roman J. Israel. Had no Bakuali in plain sight, but people still can't see it. So the snake's still showing up, stakes still high. So the race still going up. Warriors of the North Gate, we not slowing up. Born in the manger, sworn to be savior. Walk through the valley of the shadows of the depth of the slavery. Looking for life, the book of Genesis. Astroplane entrances, invoke the nemesis. Abstract images of past lives kicking in. Danger, running for your life, you're finishing.
Morris Omar, key man or oracle. Using Trinity powers, decipher allegorical. Lost in metaphorical, holy books are metaphysic. Fact slapper, dirty more or a Dru Ali critic. Calling him Thomas or Walter and get your face caved. Or cut like a close shave. Drowned in my brain waves, squash my heat waves. Activating Kundalini. Abyssinia invaded by Mussolini. Selassie I in exile.
house. Reptile and Genesis, niggas appearing real. All I see is false evidence. Yeah, all feminists, stomped on by elephants. More like more prejudice, but want moreish benefits. When you feel the full magnetic resonance, apis horns of the sacred book are maleficent. Great cosmic mothers, return to blissedness. No pestilence, ace all the testaments. Tap into remembrance, never to forget again. Use energy right, not put spell effects on men. Wandering the earth plane with more they live shades. Keeps you a mental slave as the horizon fades. It's been decades since Christian crusades. Not enough rebellions, too many visual bouquets. Holding onto the fence, burning on doomsday. War ruled by Mars, it might be on a Tuesday.
Canaan Land Moors presents Common Sense Quickie. What we do here is we add some common sense thinking to everyday situations or comments that may arise. Want to give it a try?
So, I forgot that you had the question about the taxes. So, let's just get to the point. Two things are going on. One thing that's going on is that Moors have been passive since the 1930s. Moors have been passive when it comes to civics and exercising rights. They've been passive. They haven't done jack with regard to rights since the 1930s. The reason why they were supposed to do that was so that you're not going to have yourself getting taxed right now. Because they were supposed to stick to the program that we're the indigenous people of the land. We have our own businesses. We have our own manufacturing companies and all that. We have everything. We don't need these people for anything. Right? We had Oscar the Priest in office in Congress. Right? And that was just Chicago on lockdown. You think that wasn't going to happen in every state? So then if there's a Moorish president, Moorish vice president, Moorish secretary of whatever, Moorish this and that, if there's Moorish everything, you still think you're not going to have to pay some taxes or something? Because you're a Moor, you're just inheriting everything and you don't have to give anything to the nation? No, it doesn't work like that. So that's one reason why you're getting taxed right now. Then the other part of it is that we're under occupation. Some people who have a home don't want to go home, so they're taking your stuff. And then they've been going around the world doing that to everybody. Right? So, am I going to sit there at the damn grocery store or whatever like that, arguing with these people for five notes of taxes that they charged or whatever like that? Am I really going to kill myself sitting here talking to this clerk? Because the manager already knows he's not going to really be coming to do anything. He's hiding in the back. Because they already know what's up. But if they do it for one in front of all this whole line, then they have to do it for everybody. And they're not going to do it for everybody. They shut the store down and everybody's going to starve because the Moors want to exercise their rights or whatever like that. And then these people said, nah, forget that shit. And they shut their stuff down. And then you're going to be blaming Moors. Why'd the Moors do that? The Moors, whatever like that. So we look at it like this. Taxes are only during wartime, because that's how you pay for the war. Other than that, you're supposed to be paying some type of dues or something like that. You're supposed to be paying some type of tithe. You're supposed to be paying some type of giving to your nation. And then that's the taxes. That's the real taxes. Because remember, it's fiat. It's not money. So they're not taxing you because it's not money. That's just numbers on the page. You look at that paper and you gave it to that guy. You didn't give him anything. You gave him paper. And then you walked out the store with everything. But then people are going to play the little sell a package game and try to make you think that that's a package. Oh, yeah, well, you know, when we go in there, we can take anything that we want because everything's paid for and whatever like that. And yeah, everything is paid for. That's why you're giving these people paper and you're leaving out with stuff. You don't realize you're giving them paper? Or you just swipe something, something goes beep, and then you just leave with all the stuff? Well, my account has a negative that I went to the store and... Who said that's your account? And then you start going into these rabbit holes and all that stuff when you start talking about taxes. So what you really have to look at is that taxes are only during wartime. And if there is taxes, as far as North America is concerned, the only people who should be collecting that is Congress. It's not supposed to be some tax agency of the whatever. It's not supposed to be that. Only Congress should be dealing with taxes. That's it. So it's a catch-22. You're going to put down your nationality card and not pay taxes, but then you're going to pay 1 cent. You're going to really sit there, argue with this guy for 1 cent tax? You're indigenous, put it in the thing. You're standing there for an hour for 1 cent? Or you're just going to say, forget it. Because you know the game is, it's fiat, so they're not really taxing you. You're not really getting paid at work. They just push some numbers into something for you, and now you say that you have something. But what did you have to do? The energy had to go in first before you get that thing. So it's really about the energy. It's not about the thing that you got for what you did. And then they taxed it. Right? So it's messed up. When you're talking about taxes, don't let anybody play any games with you and all that stuff about, you know, we're indigenous, we don't gotta pay and all that stuff. That's BS. Because if we're speaking lawful, then that's fiat. And then if it's fiat, then they're not taxing you. But if they're not taxing you, that doesn't mean that you shouldn't be paying a tax. Because you have a nation to uphold. So you better be a member of some type of Moorish whatever so that you can put your fiat, your exchange, or your gold, or your silver, or your time, or your whatever it is that you don't need and you think that these Moors could use it. Here it is, give it to them. All those are your taxes. More called you up, yo man, I got this issue or whatever like that, da da da. You tell him, oh, you know what? Call this more over here. He'll let you know what's up. And then that more talk to that more, and then they resolve their issue. As a unit, nobody knows about it. Nobody went live with it or anything like that. You know what I mean? They just did it. Right, you setting that up, you setting up that connection, that's you paying your stuff. But because we're in a corporate capitalist system, you're going to have some type of fiat exchange thing going on in multiple forms. Now, a whole different side, again, is if there's a Moorish everything, don't be a Moor and think, oh, well, I'm a Moor, so I don't have to pay taxes because I'm exempt from the taxes. No, you're not. This is nationhood now. So you should want to be paying taxes. You should want to be paying the most taxes. You shouldn't be running from taxes if it's for your nation, right? If it's for the corpse, yeah, for sure. Run from it, right? So it's by a case-by-case basis. It ain't something that, you know what I mean, it's going to go this way because that more did it that way. So that means for you it's going to go that way. No, it doesn't go like that. That's how they get you to buy the package, the taxes package. Because I'm sure you already bumped into Moors, Europeans, whoever, that they have this, you know, commerce thing going on over here. And it's not really the Moorish thing, but like it involves some of the language of the Moorish thing. And then you start thinking that these things are together when they're not together. They're separate. And anybody coming to you on some angle of get you out of something with your nationality, they got a package they're about to sell you. Slow down. They're about to sell you a package that's not going to work. And because you signed non-disclosure agreement and all that stuff, now you can't go after them for the fraud that they did. People's game is tight. So don't get caught up in taxes and all that stuff. Let's talk about what this is really about. Don't worry about taxes. You know, don't worry about the dumb stuff. You don't need to worry about that. While you sleep, you're paying taxes. Problem is that you're not paying your own taxes to your nation to offset the fraudulent taxes you have to pay. Because the fraudulent taxes wouldn't even matter once you're putting the taxes to your nation, because the taxes to the nation is worth more than the tax you're giving to this corpse. And again, it's not like you're giving it because they're just taking it. Because these dumbasses didn't do anything since 1930 with regard to law. And they abandoned Noble Juali, they abandoned the Moorish nation to play little temple games. And not seeing this as nation. And realize that all those temples are embassies or regencies. Consulate. That's what a temple is. Not some stuff some guy made up over there. And then they're saying that they're it. No. There's a foundation to this, and nobody wants to deal with the foundation, because if they deal with the foundation, they become unimportant. And it gets right back to where it was in 1929, before Noble Juali got assassinated. That all more seeing and knowing are going to be knowing what they're doing, because they've been studying like Juali taught them. And the new Moors with eyes wide open, seeing and knowing, have been the ones that kept this alive that you're asking about taxes right now. And these people over here in Moor Science Temple down there, you think that they're somebody. It's the ones who are doing this for the nation. And if they are using the temple is just an extra arm to get a little further. To stretch so that the finger could touch it, use the temple. Because when the finger touches, then everything's over. We're back in the seats of power. But this is what they don't want to deal with. What other people have dealt with and presented to our people, that they want to deal with everything else instead of dealing with what they really should be dealing with. Right? Now, as Moors, Moorish Americans, you know, students of Noble Juali, we already know what's up. Right? Stuff like this doesn't have to be happening. We already got books and all that stuff that people could do research. They find the book, go study. Just like everybody else who wrote a book. And there's a lot of people who put out some books. And you study and you figure this stuff out. But too many people are trying to get out of stuff when it comes to this. They're not coming into this for the intellectual base that they're going to gain. They're not coming to this because of the unity of the Moors. They're not saying that they're Moors because, you know, their children have fun knowing that they're Moors and wearing their fezes to school and all that. They're not coming into that. They're coming into this because, oh, I got a ticket. the tax people sent me. The tax people sent me a paper. And I don't know what to do, so I'm going to give this guy $7,000 and he's going to help me get rid of something. Right. So this is the new black gods. The new black gods. Edward Curtis. If Noble Drew Ali was exposed to any part of African Islamic culture, he would have been far more likely to encounter amulets rather than a bound volume of the Quran. For many West African Muslims and even non-Muslims, verses of the Quran could be placed in an amulet to ward off evil or offer protection. Often, a sheikh or religious specialist would instruct the layperson on how to use a particular amulet. Though there are many learned scholars of the Quran in West Africa, and Arabic was an important lingua franca of the region, there were also Muslims and non-Muslims who had no idea how to read what was inside their amulets. What they knew was the text as talisman. Perhaps this was the Islam to which Noble Drew Ali was exposed, if he was exposed to Islam at all. But Fawcett's ethnographic coverage of the MSTA also reminds us that any search for the meaning of religious activity to African Americans must take account of the contemporary context in which that religion exists. Rather than locating the possible sources of Noble Drew Ali's Islam only in African retentions, one must also focus on the northern cities where Moorish science was born. To place Noble Drew Ali's Islamic identity in the rich context of his time and place requires knowledge of the other forms of Islam that African Americans and others were practicing around Chicago, Detroit, and other cities through which Noble Drew Ali moved. Michael Gomez helpfully speculates that the MST may have intentionally distanced itself from Sunni or Orthodox Islam. Prophet Noble Drew Ali, after all, offered revelation directly from God, investing himself with a divine authority that for his followers superseded the claims of other Muslims vying for attention of the Black Americas in the 1920s. You get it? This is what they don't want you to know. So all those people who tell you Moors are Muslim and whatever. Michael Gomez helpfully speculates that the MSTA may have intentionally distanced itself from Sunni or Orthodox Islam. Drew Ali told Moors that the authority comes from the Quran of Muhammad, the authority. The authority. Just the authority. Nationality doesn't come from Quran of Muhammad and all that. Birthrights don't come from the Quran of Muhammad. Just the authority. That's all. No need to go nuts. Drew Ali brought us our own version so that we don't have to be following all these people's stuff. We have our own stuff. That's why he had a holy book. Because he's the prophet that brought that holy book. For the Moorish Americans, the dumbasses from North America, except the Mexicans, who don't know theirself. And they want to play Negro black colored games. And again, Michael Gomez helpfully speculates that the MST may have intentionally distanced itself from Sunni or Orthodox Islam. Prophet Noble Drew Ali, after all, he didn't play Timothy Drew and all that. He didn't play them games. Noble Drew Ali, Prophet Noble Drew Ali. This is not some debatable thing. Everybody knows what's up. The only ones who don't know are the dumbasses in North America who are still playing Negro, black, colored, African, Indian games. Everybody else knows what's up. What does Cuba have a fez on their coat of arms for? You think they don't know what's up? Why wouldn't they know what's up? Spanish, they're Moreno, not Negro. They're Moreno, not Negro. Doesn't that mean that they're not Negro, black, or colored? They're Moors in Spanish? Right. So the distancing is so that you don't get us messed up with all those other people over there that's saying Allah and Islam and all that stuff too. Because we're not those guys. We're not them. We're Moorish Americans. We're not Sunni Shiite or whatever like that. That's not who we are. That might be our religion or whatever. Ramadan has to be something that we practice, but we're practicing that as Moors. We're not practicing that as Muslims. Why bringing religion in it? You know, just like Moors know. Anytime anybody Islamic sees a Moor, they go to Sufi instead of Sunni, Shiite, Orthodox, or whatever other crap they got. It's like the Christian people. Like the Jew people. And that's the Trinity that they use to rule the world. All these people are violating nature's law for their under their religion. They're violating. Crazy violating. Prophet Noble Drew Ali, after all, offered revelation directly from God, investing himself with a divine authority that for his followers superseded the claims of other Muslims vying for attention of black Americans in the 1920s. Rather than assuming that Noble Drew Ali was ignorant of other forms of Islam, this approach tries to understand what constructions of Islam he chose to include and exclude in his teachings. The leader might have been exposed to numerous contemporaneous sources of Islamic knowledge, including Muslim immigrants from India and the Ottoman Empire, immigrant missionary tracts, African-American veterans of conflict with Muslims in the Philippines, Orientalist scholarship, the publications of the Universal Negro Improvement Association, the writings of Edward Blyden, and oral historical legends about Muslim ancestors in Africa. How do you talk about Muslim stuff and bring it up? UNIA, that's Marcus Garvey and all that. How come they're talking about Juwali's teachings coming from these different forms of Islam that were happening in America in the 1920s, and they're bringing up UNIA as Islamic? Now they played you. What do you thought? You thought you and I was some black power BS, right? Lied to you. Lied. Like Morris say, just hang these traitors. Just hang them. Because they lied. Whoever told you that UNIA is Islamic? Tell me. Tell me whoever told you that UNIA is Islamic. I bet you all you heard about UNIA is that some back to Africa BS. Red, black, green, and all that crap. Bet you. Why aren't they telling, how come it takes the new black gods to tell you that you and I is Islamic? Marcus Garvey is Islamic. Meaning black power and all that. The number of possible sources for Noble Juwali's Islam increases dramatically if one dates the establishment of the MSTA to 1925 rather than 1913. A common mistake in the secondary and tertiary literature of the MSTA is to equate Noble Juwali's establishment of the Canaanite Temple in Newark, New Jersey in 1913 with the establishment of the Moore Science Temple in Chicago in 1925. This is how much they figured out just checking Noble Juwali's stuff. You don't got to go far to figure this stuff out. Moors have libraries because they like to read. But if we need something, all we need is Noble Juwali's stuff. Oral statements, 101 questionnaire, Holy Quran, Moorish literature, and you're good. And then if you have this secret brotherhood of the East, then if you have that too, what more you need than that? To save yourself and figure this stuff out. Right? But this is how low our people are. This is how low they are. So the problem, a common mistake, is that people are going to say, oh yeah, Noble Juwali, Moore Science Temple, 1913. No, that's a lie. Somebody lied. Something's doctored here. Just check other literature, and it's telling you, not 1913. So how, where'd this stuff come from? Common mistake. Like broken telephone? Common mistake. Because people don't check the facts. Just go and check his literature. Just check his literature. Even if Noble Juwali established the MST on the East Coast before 1920, he certainly would have learned later about the Ahmadiyya movements in Chicago. One way or another, Chicago, as Susan Nance has established, was a central place for the development, if not the birth, of this movement. It was in Chicago in the 1920s where Noble Drew Ali published his Holy Quran of the Moral Science Temple. And it was in Chicago in 1928 where the Moral Science Temple was officially incorporated and where the movement used Unity Hall, located at 3140 Indiana Avenue, as its headquarters. Chicago was also an important center for the Ahmadiyya movement. Its Muslim mosque and mission house in Chicago was located by 1922 on 4448 Wabash Avenue, about 2 miles south of Unity Hall. Originally established in 1889 in the Punjab by Ghulam Ahmed, 1908, the Ahmadiyya movement was a modern messianic group that sought the revival of Islam. Oh, so they're Punjab. So they're not Aboriginal indigenous here. So whatever they have means a damn thing to us, because we already have our own stuff over here, which is what Noble Drew Ali was presenting to the Moors. That you have your own. You don't have to follow these foreigners. You following foreigners and you have your own stuff. You didn't realize you have your own stuff? You following some foreigners? Divine 39 Allah. The culture is I God. Noble Drew Ali's main contention was that the people known in America as the so-called black man, woman, and child are in reality Moors and Asiatics. Act 6 of the Divine Constitution and Bylaws of the Moor Science Temple of America reads, "With us, all members must proclaim their nationality and their divine creed, and that they may know that they are part and parcel of this said government, and that they are not Negroes, colored folks, black people, or Ethiopians, because these names were given to by slaveholders in 1779 and lasted until 1865 during the time of slavery. But this is a new era of time now, and all men must proclaim their free national name to be recognized by the government in which they live and the nations of the earth. And this is the reason Allah, the great God of the universe, ordained Noble Drew Ali, the prophet, to redeem his people from their sinful ways. The Moorish Americans are descendants of the Asiatic Moabites, whom inhabited the northwestern and southwestern shores of Africa, also northeast and southeast shores of the Americas. Prophet Noble Drew Ali immediately rallied many Moors to his temples, with the green five-point star on the red background as the Asiatic flag. Nothing can stop the movement except the Moors. Taught in the Far East and possessing powerful speeches with a persuasive manner and a Native American shrewdness that enabled him to teach the poor, rich, learned, and unlettered people and all who would listen. Most of them remembered the race riots of 1919. All of them had experienced discrimination, segregation, and other wrongs. Drew Ali offered them pride and dignity with knowledge of self and God. In 1928, a successful convention provided Noble Drew Ali with an expansion of his temple activities in other cities. It is not difficult to ascertain just how many temples resulted because of record keeping by the Moors in cities like Pittsburgh, Detroit, Charleston, West Virginia, Lansing, Michigan, Youngstown, Ohio. Drew Ali had divinely prepared and published his Circle 7 Quran, a book consisting of the life of Jesus and the science of life in degrees to follow. The prophet did business in various oils and teas and had divinely prepared among them a Moorish blood purifier, bath compounds, and other Moorish remedies that work and that are still in use in temples of Moor science today. Asiatics flocked to the Star and Crescent. They wore their fezes on the street and the Europeans stopped treating them with contempt. The prophet did business in various oils and teas. He had divinely prepared among them a Moorish blood purifier, bath compounds, and other Moorish remedies that work and that are still in use in temples of Moorish science today. Asiatics flocked to the Star and Crescent. Asiatics, remember, we're talking about the time of Zhu Ali, right? We're talking about the time of Zhu Ali. Asiatics flocking to the Star and Crescent. And who's the people that rep the Star and Crescent? No? Oh, NOI, right? But they had to flip it around, because if they left it the right way, then you would know that they got it from Zhu Ali. So they flip it. They flip it so that you don't connect it to Zhu Ali. Keep in mind, Asiatics flocked to the Star and Crescent. Don't they say Asiatic black man? Why didn't they say Asiatic Moor? Why they put black man in there? Why'd they lie? And why would they lie? Why would they put black man on there? Right, to do that is lying. Because these people have influence, which means they're lying to their people. And their people are believing the lie. How come this brother found out that Europeans start treating Moors with contempt when they start acting like Moors, looking like Moors, dressing like Moors? Like what? The prophet announced that each devoted Moorish American must carry a nationality card bearing his or her real name with title, signed by the prophet, with an Asiatic seal. Today, slave names are amended and real ones added with the use of the Ninth Amendment of the U.S. Constitution. The titles are El or Bey, signifying Moorish nobility. The nationality card, Star and Crescent, which displayed to Europeans somehow convinced the European that the bearer was an enlightened Moorish American. The prophet found independence for the Moors, ethical and theoretical. Reports from newspapers wrote about street brawls, threats, insults, and minor violence centering on the Asiatic Americas. Moors were approaching Europeans on the streets, showing their nationality card and flags, and proclaiming in the name of their prophet, Noble Zhu Ali and Allah, that they had been freed of European slave names and mindset. After all this was done by the Moors, Zhu Ali issued the following law in the book called Humanities. I hereby warn all Moors that they must cease from all radical or agitating speeches while on their jobs or in their homes or on the streets. Stop flashing your cards at Europeans as it causes confusion. We did not come to cause confusion. Our work is to uplift the nation. Our work is to uplift the nation. Our work is to uplift the nation. As soon as you see no uplifting the nation happening, know that you're dealing with some traitors. As soon as you see that is going in the direction that It's power tripping. It's over and beyond what's good and moral. Into some other realms. I don't even know what the hell is going on here. Because Dru Ali told the Moors, laid it all out. Like we said, you just have his four things, you go through that, and you're good. You will see what he meant. You will see where he was going with this, where he went with it. And you would realize what it is you have to do. If you really think, you know, some stuff is coming out of the clouds or whatever like that, and the mothership's coming to bring the help or whatever like that, you're tripping. You better start paying your taxes, find some Moorish body that's doing good work, start paying your taxes and getting involved in uplifting the nation. I don't care what you got to do. You figure it out. And let's uplift the nation. Look at the struggle with uplifting fallen humanity is because majority of them don't want to learn. Majority of them don't want to know. So you realize that this is about a sojourn. And then when you are on your path and you're going where you're supposed to go, automatically you're going to resonate, and that is going to pick up other people who are resonating on the same frequency you're resonating on, and then you get together and get some stuff done. Right, and then those two resonate, and then it's going to be four, and then they resonate, and then somebody's going to come in with the family, and someone's going to come in with the uncle who has the whatever that we need for. But it starts with self. It starts with recognizing that we're also fallen humanity. Like, not just mother who's fallen, but don't forget, because she's fallen, we're fallen too. So we also need help, right? This is where it comes with us being honest with ourselves and whatever like that in order to get the help that we need, because, you know, just like everything else, it's out there. You know? It's definitely out there. It all starts with self. You can't be messing around with putting on my air and your air is not on yet. You can't tell me you're drowning and then you're trying to save me from drowning. It's not going to work. So you first deal with yourself, and it's gonna hit you. You know what I mean? You're gonna be in the zone and know that, yes, now I can. And then you go on to the next thing that you're supposed to do. Right? Because it's a sojourn. Like this is born alone, die alone. Real easy equation. That's just where it's at. That's where it's at. Checking with self. Once self is grounded properly, then you can start talking about some other stuff. The problem is that people don't want to ground properly. Because the information is so enticing You know, they just want to, you know, do the run and jump. No, don't be enticed. Don't be enticed. Like we say, measure twice, cut once. Maybe cutting 5-6 times, you end up with no wood. So, slow down. Put down the saw and all that stuff. Put down the saw. Let's get our boots first, and let's get our gloves first, and let's get out these shorts. You know what I mean? Let's prioritize. Especially after lockdown, and people are still dumb. Oh yeah, definitely. Focus on self. Because people are not supposed to be more dumb after you locked in the house for so long. You're supposed to be on, you know, cloud 5 million when you get out. You're supposed to be in the hibernation, getting it in. You know, this stuff's not gonna last forever. But no. People are living in fear in their own house. You know how crazy that is? You know how crazy it is that you're home and you're scared? Crazy. Because they don't focus on self. They're looking at all some other stuff out there, have them going nuts. Stuff that's not even concerning them. Have them tripping. Yeah, all that is the, for example, we learned from Bobby Hemmett years ago. No fear, no guilt. If you're gonna make it, guilt and fear needs to be abolished if you're gonna make it. As soon as you start talking about, well, I didn't want to hurt their feelings because the... As soon as you start going there, you already know that guilt. You don't want to be guilty. You want to be sure that all your actions were actions that you would take. And you do it again if you had the choice again. No fear, no guilt. No fear the emotion, and no fear false education appearing real. Which means I'm going to be studying, and then the studying is going to make you even, you know, more strong. Yeah, the sorcerers did a good job. I did hear that truth getting hammered in. You can't make this stuff up. They're just hammering. Everybody knows what's up. Just hammering. Think that's not the ancestors letting you know. Why is it hammering? That's the same apartment they're still working on. Peace and love to all the boys. Honors to all the boys worldwide. Honors to all the mothers. Have a great holy day tomorrow, Moors. We got this. All is well for the Moors. Honors to all the Moors in the chat. Peace and love. And Islam. Islam was...